thank all veterans and auxiliary, as well as active servicemen and women, for their service to the community and country during times of war and peace. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce the AFL people. Please stand and remain silent as our colors advance. Thank you, Legion and Auxiliary. Please remain standing and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing for our national anthem led by Ms. Bell and the High School Choir. Thank you. Please be seated. On the 11th night, the 11th day, the 11th month, we celebrate the acting of the armistice between Germany and the Allied Nations. This armistice was first proclaimed in 1918, with President Wilson declaring the day to be filled with solemn pride in the heroism of those who died in the country's service and of gratitude for the victory. In the United States, Veterans Day annually falls on November 11th, commemorating the signing of the armistice and the hostilities of the First World War.
One theory proposing a moment of silence as a way of showing honor dates back to November 1919. Australian journalist Edward George Lennon wrote to the London Evening News, suggesting that the anniversary of the armistice ending World War I be marked with 5 silent minutes of national remembrance. This proposal was brought to the attention of King George V, who declared on November 17, 1919, that on the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month, there may be, for the brief space of 2 minutes, complete suspension of all our normal activities, so that perfect stillness of
Thank you for having us here today. Really appreciate it here at the Cape Dollar meeting both of you. My name is Jim Jeff, I'm the commander. All who have served in the United States Armed Forces swore an oath to protect our country with their lives. Approximately 1 million of them died in the U.S. wars dating back to the Revolutionary War. It's up to all of us to provide a nation worthy of such sacrifice and service. I'd like to invite all veterans to please stand at this time. In the audience, everyone, I have a message for you, specifically. You have honorably served your nation with great distinction. We can't say it enough for your service in the wars and in peace. Thank you. God bless all of our veterans. And God bless the United States of America. Thank you.
As Catherine Meekes made her 2,000 mile journey across the United States in 1890, she was inspired by all she saw. Wheat fields in Kansas, the Rocky Mountains in Colorado, and everything in it. So inspired, in fact, that the English professor had the lyrics to America the Beautiful, reflecting on this song over 100 years later. Author Lynn Sher says, "I love this. I think it's simple, I think it's emotional, and I think it talks about a country, a land, and a sea. Not just about a flag, not just about a battle. It doesn't talk about conquest, it talks about the possibilities of a nation." The VW Choir, under the direction of Miss Bell, will share America the Beautiful with us today.
majestically over great institutes of learning. I stand guard with the greatest military power in the world. Look up and see me. I stand for peace, honor, truth, and justice. I stand for freedom. I'm confident. I'm arrogant. I am proud. When I am alone with my fellow families, my head is a little higher, my colors a little truer. I bow to no one. I am recognized all over the world. I am worshipped. I am saluted. I am respected. I am revered. I am loved. And I am feared. I have fought every battle of every war for more than 200 years. Gettysburg, Shiloh, Maddox, San Juan Hill, the trenches of France, the Argonne Forest, Anzio, Rome, the beaches of Normandy, the deserts of Africa, the cane fields of the Philippines, the rice paddies and jungles of Guam, Okinawa, Japan, Korea, Vietnam, and a score of places long forgotten by all but those who were with me. I was there. I led my soldiers. I followed them. I watched over them. They loved me. I was on a small hill in Iwo Jima, and I was dirty, battle-worn, and tired, but my soldiers cheered me, and I was proud. I have been soiled, burned, torn, and trampled on the streets of countries I have helped set free. It does not hurt, for I am invincible. I have been soiled, burned, torn, and trampled on the streets of my country, and when it is by those with whom I have served in battle, but I shall overcome, for I am strong. I have slipped the bonds of earth and stand watch over the uncharted new frontiers of space for my future point on the moon. I have been a silent witness to all of America's finest powers, but my finest power comes when I am torn into strips to be used for bandages for my wounded comrades on the field of battle. When I fly at half mast to honor my soldiers, and when I lie in the trembling arms of a grieving mother at the graveside of her fallen son, I am proud. My name is Old Glory. Dear God, long may I wait.
We close the day program the same week the military closes their day, with the plane attack. The most widely circulated attack for all in story is that of the Union officer, infantry officer, Captain Robert Alcom. The story claims Alcom found the two in the pocket of his son's Confederate shoulder uniforms after he was killed during the peninsula campaign. Alcom then ordered played at his son's funeral to honor the boy's memory. Please stand for the planned attack by UP and Congress.
Thank you.
Thank you. Please remain standing as the American Legion retires the flags.
We would like to extend a special thank you to our American Legion and Auxiliary, active servicemen and women, community members, and all of you for joining us today at this day's program. We invite all Legion and